What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, where we discuss software engineering by example. And this is our software engineering talk, where we pick a topic and we just casually talk about it, right? And today's topic is user experience versus the API. Which comes first, right? Any modern software or application that you design always have these two pieces somewhere or another, right? So it must have these two pieces. There's always a backend, right, where the API lives, and there is a front end consuming that API in some sort. Whether that user experience is on a mobile phone or a web, right, web page, website, or even Alexa, like a voice controlled user experience, touch, augmented reality, anything, right? The user experience. There's always the backend, which is like a bunch of APIs that the user experience consumes, right? And usually these are REST APIs most of the time. Okay, so let's start defining those two, and then we'll talk about, if you want to design an application, what should you start with? Should you start with the backend? Should you start with the front end, right? So let's get to it. So the API, what is an API? An API is a set of, so it stands for application programming interface, where you have a set of methods or functions or procedures that your application or your consumer can call and get information out of it. And then regardless what the API looks like, the API could be a C# application with a bunch of interfaces, right? So you have an interface, right? Or it could be web-based on the HTTP protocol, REST or SOAP, right? We made a few videos on REST and SOAP. Check out this or here, I don't know. I don't know where that will be, but it will be somewhere here. Yeah, so the API could be written in any kind of language, right? And exposed in any kind of protocol, starting back in the 70s, where it was just RPC, remote RPC, a core bot, or those kind of things. And back until today, which is like REST API, and it's even improving more, making it more and more flexible using the GraphQL model Facebook that developed, right, to make APIs much, much, much more flexible. So REST APIs are essentially the current modern API architecture, where it's based on the HTTP model, stateless, and we made a few videos about stateless versus stateful. What's the difference? I'll reference it here. Okay, and it's based on HTTP protocol, right? And the return usually is JSON, which the consumer, most consumers know how to understand, how to consume, right? Applications, right? And then recently it's being changed to protocol buffer because we realized, hey, APIs shouldn't really need to be human readable, right? So I can send things in binary. Users won't consume the API immediately or directly, right? People will basically write apps or clients that consume these APIs. Okay, the other side from the equation here is the experience, the user experience. And the user experience could be, as we discussed, right, could be a simple mobile app written in iOS and Android, BlackBerry, if you're still using these things, right? Oh, wait, we have Microsoft, right? Microsoft, yeah. We have Windows phones now. Yeah. Web, right? Website, voice controlled, Alexa, Google Home, Apple, whatever that thing called, HomePod, what's called, I forgot. Apple code, pod, no. Yeah. So the user experience is what consumes this API, right? Well, it's simple. And you try to build the user experience in a way that is So the user can get things done in as few clicks or commands as possible, right? So that's a better user experience, right? If the user clicks like 7 times to print something, right, or get something done, then it's not really a good user experience. But it is a user experience, regardless or not, right? It is a user experience. All right, so that's basically a user experience. So now you have, as a programmer, as a software engineer, you're responsible to design both, right? Some companies, there will be backend designer, API designer, there will be user experience. I personally think that you have to be both, right? A software engineer has to be empathetic and have to be thinking about both sides of the coin here and build applications using both models. Okay. So the question now, after 6 minutes, we get to the question finally, which should you start with? Should you start with the REST API or the API first when you design your application? Or should you start with maybe the user experience first, right? So let's just explore both. There are no right or wrong answers, guys, here. So there's always like a, what do you call this? Like a trade-off. Yeah, between the two. So let's start. What if I designed the API first? So let's take an example first, right, guys? I think with an example, things become more clear. And let's assume I'm building the YouTube piece for viewing a user videos, list of videos, right? So let's start with that, okay? So the user will click on something and he will be or she will be able to list all their videos essentially, right? And they will be able to scroll and get more videos and whatever, right? So that's the user experience. So that's a requirement, build a video API. So let's assume we have the database, it's already configured, maybe not, right? So maybe as a backend designer, you are responsible to do that. You are responsible to design the database. You are responsible to do that stuff. So let's start, if I blindly, someone told me that, right? Just videos, go ahead, right? So if I started with the API first, I don't know. I would build it in a very generic way because I have no idea. I have no requirements, right? I have no requirements. I know that we're building a video API where could be like an endpoint where the user request /user/videos and there must be some authentication method. I'm not gonna worry about that, but I will return essentially all the user video. So now the question is, okay, what should I return? Should I return what does a video have? No clue, right? This is like video ID, description, name, title, thumbnail, obviously. Because you start thinking, right? So it's like you start thinking about the user experience, but not really, because you're worried about how you're gonna build the tables at the back end, whether you wanna use a SQL-based database or a NoSQL-based database. You're worried about all these decisions that you have to make. You really don't care, right, about the user experience right now, right? And if you work with companies, you'll see this struggle fight between the back-end guys and the front-end guys, and people thinking, oh, we're the best, right? Everybody's the best, right? Everybody thinks they're the best, essentially. But essentially, if you start with that, you're going to build a very generic API, right? So I don't know. Maybe you're going to return everything, right? What are you going to think? Okay, if I return everything, I'm going to select a star, which is very expensive to compute, and then all these questions, right? So you don't have much to go with if you start with the video, with the API first, right? You're going to build it a very generic way. And advantage of that is you're going to finish the API first, right? And you might build it for multiple user experience. Okay, that's a good thing. You're going to finish fast. You're going to build it for multiple user experiences. Okay, and you try to optimize based on that generic approach, right? So you'll build certain indexes, but you still don't know, right, what the user knows. So you start to add more stuff. That's coming to the disadvantage of things. You start to add more stuff that you don't really need, or the users might not even need, right? You return stuff that the user might not even need, okay? And or you might forget things that the user actually wants. So you start building this API, but it's blind, just like based on blind faith. You go, I'm gonna build this, and let's see what the user wants, right? Okay, so there are advantages and disadvantages for both, right? So you'll have a little bit more freedom, right? You can optimize, right? You're gonna build this generic, so for multiple user experiences, but at the same time, you might run into trouble with the once the user experience come to the place, because the user experience might actually need more stuff, so you might redesign things in the future. If you start with the user experience, then you're gonna define, that's my user experience. If I click this, I'm gonna show, right? And you're gonna see that I'm biased towards the user experience first, very clearly here. But again, I'm not posing my my opinion at all, guys. You can let me know what you think in the user in the comments below. But if I start with the user experience first, then you'll have the ability to define the requirements, essentially, right? So I need the video API, right? I need to click, I need the thumbnail, I need the title, I need the description. Guess what? I actually need to show, right, the number of likes here, okay? And maybe the number of comments, but not necessarily the comments, the list of comments of this video, because I don't really care. See, as a user experience, you don't care about performance. If you think about it, well, that's not really true, but you care about the user experience more, right? Versus the API, you care about performance and optimizing your queries. So is the user better here? Is the user experience better, right? Or is the user here, is the, what do you call this, like, favor? You favor the user versus the API? I don't know. So we'll think about it, right? So it's like, okay, I want the number of comments. Maybe you can't show the comments for each video. It just doesn't make any sense, right? But you start loading all this stuff in the videos, and then you say, okay, I'm by number of likes, I want this. I just want, as I start loading, I can't load more than, because I have limited memory in my, like, whatever application. Now this is comes like to a niche application. In my iOS, I'm gonna reserve certain amount of memory, and I can't load more than 30 videos, right? Like, this 30 videos, not the actual blob of video. I'm just talking about the actual description and names and metadata of the videos. Now it's okay, I want to just load the 30 videos, and as I scroll more, I want to query more, right? So I just define, I want 30. So that's your pages, right? So you just define paging, you based on the user experience, right? Okay, you're not thinking about performance, you're thinking about the mobile device, you're thinking about the coda of the mobile device, you think about the memory of the mobile device, all these things. And as you start scrolling, you start loading all that stuff. Now you take all this data that you collected, that requirement, and then you push it to the back end and say, okay, guys, or you, even you, right? You now design the API. It says, okay, based on these requirements, I only need the title and the name and the description and whatever, right? I need this information. I don't need the rest. Don't return it. Don't suffocate the bandwidth for information that I'm not gonna use in the user experience to begin with, right? So that's the advantages. You will start optimize and make the API efficient for that user experience. Here's the catch though. If you made that API custom to this user experience, then it might break on other user experiences, right? So my work for this user experience, which is the phone, right? But it might break actually in the web or my other and the other in the desktop user experience. It doesn't work at all. So you might need to tweak the API differently, right? So you gain and you lose, right? So which is best, right? Which is best? Do you start from the API or you start in the user experience, right? There are advantages and disadvantages of both. And I'm gonna pass the question back to you guys. What do you think? If you wanna build an API or even a build application, what do you design first? Do you design the API first or design the user experience first, right? Let me know in the comment, below. And that's all for us today. And check out the other contents of this channel. We discuss software engineering, by example. We just got a lot of software stuff in this channel. And I'm gonna see you in the next one, guys. You stay